It's gonna be busy the next few weeks. We have a cow that's about to have birth right now. Goats over there, they're eating their Christmas trees. We have people that leave us Christmas trees that they like to munch on. So I'm gonna make a quick video on making a feeder. All right, so this is our IBC tote feeder. I've already taken the tote out. There was two bars up on top here that I had to unscrew with a star bit, and then I pulled it out really easy. I tip this on its side and then I just yank it out. It's not hard. What we do is we are going to cut on the long side. We're going to leave the long side as the hay feeder itself. We're going to use the short side as the side. We're going to cut this and this, but I'm going to cut on this side and this side. I've seen a lot of people just cut in the middle. They push it in, but it leaves really, really sharp edges. So I'm going to do it, and then I will show you what goes after that. So I'm going to cut this and this off all the way down, except for the bottom. We're going to leave the bottom one. So this one right here, we're going to leave. So that's three. I'm going to cut three of them. I'm going to leave the top. So I do that on all four sides. So I'm going to get my grinder. Worn my coveralls that I got for 25 cents. I still got to sew up my leg, but every time I think about it, then something else happens. So I haven't gotten there yet. I think they might have to retire this year, though, after we do a burst. But this is my birthing outfit, and I'm waiting for a cow right now and a goat. Button's annoying. It doesn't stay. Should also wear safety glasses and gloves. Don't do what I'm doing. Thank you. We're gonna cut along the bottom here, and I'm actually gonna flip it upside down so that I'm not having to lean over to cut it. All right. Okay, got my gloves. There's my goggles. Find my bug eyes. These things are like horrible. Okay, so I cut the bottom. You see this is loose. I just moved it up on the side like this, which is another reason I put stuff on, because I'm getting sparks flying back on my all the time when I'm doing this.
So we're gonna push this in. Well, it's really easy to do. Okay, I just had surgery. I've been in bed for 8 weeks, and I basically had everything from my belly button down completely reconstructed. Every body part there is. So I do have to be careful with what I'm doing. And trying to build muscle up right now is bad. It hurts. Okay, so I brought these together. I'm going to cut these off. I'm using baling twine right now because I want to make sure it's going to work for goats. If I have to cut a goat out real fast, I can at least just cut the twine and not have to mess with wire.
Carl will get fed.
So I learned pretty quickly that I need to put some wire to make it so the hay doesn't just fall all the way through, as they were really devouring this super fast.
I'm using zip ties to attach it. That way, if we have an emergency, I can just snip the zip ties and it stays safer. This one has the metal sheets on it, the side. I think there was some of the other ones, but my friend took them off and then he got rid of them. So I'm going to keep these on because it's just less space for a goat to stick their head in. And then put wire in here and just make it so the hay lasts longer and they're not pulling it out so fast. So then they don't get so bored. Okay, so here we go. I took some wire and I put it down here, and then I zip tied it at the bottom and zip tied it at the top, and I kind of wrapped it around. If I had wider wire, I would go all the way to the end. This is what I have right now, so this is what's going to happen. It's going to be here. And then if I can run across some other wire, I will change it out. Not really difficult to do. So some people actually cut the bottom of the plastic out and put it at the bottom. I'm not going to do that. I live in the desert. And even if I didn't, I wouldn't do it. Because this allows water to drain out and urine. And it would be really easy for me to just come in here and hose it out. Carl, you're standing in my way. Hi, Carl. Carl. You want me to put food in here, don't you? So I'm not going to be doing that. Okay, so that's a lot better. They're slowing down on their eating. Not much is dropping down compared to before. So I wired up the other one, and yeah, it took me 20 minutes, guys. 20 minutes and you have a feeder.